Baker, we might as well get it over with, you know, just beat the hell out of each other. I'm waiting on my brother, though, because I like to fight with him.
Oh, you got
to
back up.
But, you know, the thing that gets me is, like, we both played at Oklahoma.
See, I don't get that.
Yeah, I did, no, man. It's Southwest Oklahoma.
He's trying to butter you.
It's not the same.
I don't get it. But, you know, in all seriousness, this was based on – my comments were based on expectations. Mm-hmm. And I think when I look at it, you had a tremendous rookie year. And you add one of the best receivers in the game, Odell Beckham, and then it's just like, what the – I had you guys win in the division. Yeah. What the hell happened? Like, what went wrong?
Well, none of the stuff that happens year prior carries over. We all at this table know that. And it comes down to me doing my job. I've never turned the ball over so many times. I mean, that might have been the most combined over my whole career. And you can't win like that. And so that falls back on me. I'll take all the blame for that. And so it comes back on communication, just being on the same page, doing my job the best I can and not worrying about the outside stuff, not replying to you, not telling you that orange and brown don't matter, but just doing my job and doing what really matters, being a quarterback.
Yeah, that's amazing, though, because to me, like, that tells me right there that you're starting to get it. And because I question, like, I always said this. I go, when it goes wrong, you know we're going to get blamed. As a head coach and as a quarterback, we're going to take all the criticism when it doesn't go right. Mm-hmm. And I load it on you because, I mean, I was frustrated with it.
Yeah.
But the thing it shows me right there is, like, if things go bad, when you start with I when things go bad, that's a great thing.
And we when it's all going right.
Absolutely. And to me, that's what you do as a head coach and as a quarterback. And, the thing is right now, you're already talking, you know, that I'm like, he gets it. And so, to me, that was what I had a big question on. Did you get it? And you know, it's interesting because at the time, I'm a mouse turd, you're a hunting elephant. You know what I mean? And so, to me, that was why I was surprised that you, not just going back at me, but going back at other other people. And because that doesn't help you win games.
No, it doesn't. And that's what the focus needs to be about is, what can I do to help this team win? What can I do to make our franchise better, head in the right direction, do the things of why I was picked in that spot, and make it happen.
Let's talk about the expectations, because there's no question that was a difference. You were drafted by a team that was 1-31 in consecutive seasons. So anything that was accomplished was considered a great success, and it was unquestionably a successful rookie year. Then you come back the next year with the additions, and all of a sudden the expectations are from Dan and from Rex and many others. You're going to win a division. You're going to make a deep playoff run. How did that change things for you?
You know what? We in our own building set our own expectations extremely high, much like everybody else thought. And so it was disappointing for us. I wouldn't say that the outside noise affected us really. We might have paid a little bit of attention to it, but the talks that we had inside that locker room, inside our building, were all about winning. They were all about heading in the right direction. So as soon as it went wrong, that was the frustrating part. It was like, what is going on here? We all want this thing to work, but it's not. And so trying to find the problem and figure it out was what we, you know what, it just kind of slipped past us.
Now that y'all got all that kumbaya out the way, I expected more out of you, Rex.
I did. What do you mean?
I'm just messing with you. Here's the thing for me, babe. I watched you in college, mm-hmm. covered you, tremendous player. I watched you. The problem that I had was the willingness and commitment to continue talking to people that didn't matter. Mm-hmm. That was my biggest issue. And I know people talked about the chip on your shoulder, and I said it a million times. In the league, they don't care about a chip on your shoulder. No. It's grown men. What did you learn about the dynamics of the NFL that you couldn't translate that kind of MO from college?
It's a humbling experience. It's a different ball game. Let's just be honest. I put my foot in my mouth a lot this past year, and I'm going to internalize that, and I think that's the way I need to handle it. I mean, rest in peace, Kobe, but that's the way he did it.
Yeah.
He motivated himself. He didn't talk a lot. He talked to his teammates, drove them to be better people, better men, and so that's the way I need to handle it. I don't need to respond to the things that don't matter. The things that don't help us win.
That's
interesting to me because you are the former walk-on and has had success at Tech and then had success at Oklahoma and then obviously the rookie year. But you're also the person who said, I'm not going to change. I'm going to be me.
Yeah.
And so are you now telling us that because of this experience and because this is our first time that we have all seen Baker fail, that you are going to change, that you're going to learn and become a different version of Baker?
No, I think where it comes along is I've always had a chip on my shoulder, but I always played with an edge. But – it didn't come around to people noticing it until the cameras were all around, until it was a big deal where I was getting the spotlight and people made a big deal of that. I just have to be me. I have to continue to do that, but I don't need to reply to the stuff on the outside. I don't need to let the bigger picture.
But you can still keep the chip on your shoulder and not do that?
You'll still use that same dog? I can keep both boulders right there and let's go. And so I need to internalize that and motivate everybody else around me.
What I respect about what you just said, I made mention to it to G a million times throughout the season, being a veteran guy in the league, I'm like, who in the hell ordained Baker to speak for people? That was my issue. Mm-hmm. And you know, as teammate, if I was in that locker room, I'm coming to you and say, Bake, don't speak on issues that ain't got nothing to do with Bake if it ain't in a positive light. So what you said, and look, this is the advice that I would give you from a guy that's just been around this league. Change ain't bad if it's evolution. Right? You just evolving.
That's right.
And my whole issue this past year was like, why does he – same thing with Kyrie a couple weeks ago. I said Kyrie and Baker problem is they talk too damn much to people that don't matter, mm-hmm. right? I know Jarvis. I know Odell. I know them.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? They are going – you are in a position where they are going to look to you for direction, regardless if you want to believe it or not and how great of players they are. So I think hearing you say that just now, bro, that kudos to you, man, because that's the part that a lot of former players had a problem with when I would talk in circles like, Bake need to chill. He ain't really done nothing yet.
I like the evolution. Yeah. I like the evolution.
And my point would be that you take you have those alpha males and Odell Beckham, Jarvis Landry. You got two Pro Bowl running backs. All right. You got great pieces right there. There's no question about it. But when we're going to see the Cleveland Browns in a Super Bowl is when all those pieces are like this. And absolutely. The most important thing and the only thing that you talk about is not how many catches Odell has or how many touchdowns you throw or interceptions, whatever. It's what we do collectively.
We're so glad you're watching ESPN on YouTube.
For more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app.
And for live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN Plus. We'll see you there.